You know, you're asked the question about how to balance activism with your practice. I don't know, I kind of interpret that as how do you balance activism with a life, having a life. And it's interesting because a few days ago I took a walk with a neighbor, a friend, and once a month, she goes up to detention centers in the Central Valley and she talks to two separate people and just listens to their stories. And the stories are devastating. Serial rape, being kicked out of the country even though you're a citizen and have lived here for, I don't know, 15, 20 years. And then now I have other friends who work in housing. They work with the homeless. They work with building new housing. They work with representing homeless and people being kicked out of housing in the courts. Then I also have friends who are professors. You know, I dated a UCLA professor, and during that time, she did this really wonderful photography project with Native American youth in Los Angeles, a lot of whom were homeless. And then at the end, she did an art show at the museum, whatever that museum is in Griffith Park, whatever it's called. And, you know, the other thing too is I think professors, among many others, also set the conversations that we use in activism, inclusionary, to being inclusive, various ways we talk about it. So I'm highly respectful of all of that. What happened for me when I decided to go to Lesbos Island is that I just knew I had to do it. It wasn't something, well, I think I want to do this. How am I going to do this? How should I do this? It was just something I knew, but there was just no other way around it. And so then what happened is somebody asked if they could come along, and then somebody else knew someone that had apartments that lived on the island and knew someone who had apartments for rent. So that's one way that's how I made that decision. And I think this is really a key because at the moment, a friend and I are thinking about, we're working on doing a workshop in Orange County in the next few months. It's going to be about narrative. How do you write, whether it's you're making a film, whether you're writing an essay, or maybe you're doing an activist project. How do you stay with the process and not let the voices get in the way and not let expectations get in the way? What would it look like? What is it, you know, in other words, what am I expected to do here? And one of the points about that is if you're writing an essay or doing an activist project, let's say for an example, I'm writing an essay, I don't know what the ending is going to be necessarily. So do I feel comfortable enough to just keep doing it anyway? And that at a certain point, if ideas start to interfere, what this should end up looking like, or, oh, I want to write it this way or that way, and I lose my way, then I can kind of go back to the point where I had that feeling of, okay, staying in the process and staying in the, not flow exactly, but staying in the feeling of this is something I have to do. So, and when you're doing something like that, this is not just activism versus practice. It refers to the practice and activism, that everything you do is part of your narrative, and so that you check in, what do I want to do here? Where's that deep feeling? It's difficult when you're going to change a behavior or something because it's going to be uncomfortable in a different way because you're doing something you aren't doing. But can you stay in the feeling of going to do this? I don't know what it's going to end up looking like, but can I feel comfortable to follow through with it? So that's kind of how, at the moment, I see that. And so that's how I make decisions at the moment.